world champion.
Best. You can be the King Kong banging on your chest.
You could beat the world, you could beat the war. You could talk the guy, go banging on his door.
You can throw your hands up, you can beat the clock,
yeah.
You can move a mountain, you can break rocks.
You could be a master, don't wait for luck. Dedicate yourself and you go find yourself.
Standing in the Hall of Fame. You can run the mile. You can walk straight through hell with a smile.
You could be the hero, you could get the gold. Breaking all the records you thought never could be broke.
Yeah, do it for your people, do it for your pride. And you're never gonna know if you never even try.
Do it for your country, do it for your name. Cause there's gonna be a day when you're
standing in the Hall of Fame.
Yeah.
And the world's gonna.
Politicians be preachers, yeah. Be believers, be leaders, be astronauts, be champions, be truth seekers, be students, be teachers, be politicians, be preachers,
yeah.
Be believers, be leaders, be astronauts, be champions.
Standing in the Hall of Fame.
There are two tables here. Thank you very much. At this time, may I request that we all stand for the national anthem. Mr. Chewe, please. We shall start at the count of three, all of us at once. One, two, three, start.
Praise be, bless our brethren.
Zambia, Zambia, free men we stand under the flag of our land. Zambia, praise to thee, O one strong and free.
Thank you so much. You may be seated. At this time, I will ask Mapalo Chitamfia to come and offer a prayer.
Shall we bow our heads and pray? Our dear Heavenly Father, I want to thank you for this wonderful day. Father, we thank you for giving us the opportunity to write our exams today. Father, we thank you and I pray that you may bless the head of this institution. Father, I pray and ask that you may thank everyone in this room in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray and thank you for the catering that has come here today. I pray for the guest of honor in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray for each and every parent who is able to come here in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you so much. At this time, let me just let the August House know that in our midst we have our guest of honor, the Honourable Minister of Agriculture, of Local Government, sorry, Mr. Vincent Mwale. We have in our midst the Managing Director, Mr. Chisha Folotia, and other dignitaries. So you are most welcome. This is a send-off party for our young ones. This is a class of 2017, the first ever at Woodford School Lusaka. At this time, I will ask for some nice, cool music. This is a luncheon program, and we will ask that the ushers will usher the dignitary's face to the table behind, and then that will be followed by the class of 2017, and then the other tables will be let, they'll let you know as your time comes. May I have some music? May I request that we begin with the highest table? Thank you.
Thank you.
So much. As we enjoy our meals, we'll continue with the program. At this time, let me invite in our beautiful young boys and girls, our class of 2017. There's those who have called us to gather like this. Give us some music for them.
Thank you. Pupils and Hamwenda, Kontazani and Chuwenwe. Then we have Mapala and Kalipe. And finally we have Chengelo.
Managing Director, the PTA Chairperson, the Head Teacher, ladies and gentlemen, at this time, may I take this opportunity to introduce and invite the Head Teacher, Mrs. Siawanta. A big hand to you.
Guest of Honor, Honourable Vincent Mwale, Minister of Local Government, the Managing Director, Ms. Trisha Lawrence, volunteer. The PTA Chairperson, Mr. Raymond Goma. Dear parents and guardians, teachers, boys and girls, good afternoon. Okay. We welcome you to the first Grade 7 send-off luncheon. It is a happy moment for us as a school that today we have finally to have our first grade 7 children write the national composite examination. Honourable Vincent Mwale, may I confess that these children wrote the examinations under the guidelines from the Examinations Council of Zambia in conjunction with the Ministry of Education. We followed all procedure, and this morning we delivered their answer cards to to the Zono Strong Room for further processing. It is a very special day when we are sending off these children we've had from, I think the earliest came in grade four as little boys and girls. Today, they look beautiful. You look beautiful, boys and girls. It all started as a joke when one parent for the twins, the boys, Mr. Lungu, made a follow-up of his earlier inquiry for space for the two boys. He actually communicated to me mid-2013 while I was still at Rhodes Park School. And then when I told him I had moved to Woodford School Lusaka, he said, "Mrs. Yabata, I'll follow you." I didn't know who I was dealing with. And that day came, he came to make the inquiry, the boys came for the assessment, and voila, the rest of the parents followed. The class was made. Thank you, Mr. Lungu, for opening the doors. I also take the opportunity to thank all of you, our dear parents and guardians, for trusting us with your children so that we could prepare for them, we could prepare them for the grade 7 examinations. We've done our best and we're confident that we will produce good results. We have been monitoring the performance of these children, even yourselves, through the fortnight booklets that you were receiving every 2 weeks, and we believe that their performance in the final examination will surely be better than what you've been seeing in those little booklets. I must mention that for the past few months, these pupils have been put under serious drilling to prepare them for the examination. No wonder they had no half day on Fridays. They had no full 4 weeks holidays. Honourable Minister, we hope you will not arrest us or condemn us for denying these children 2 weeks in April and 2 weeks in August. We just wanted to prepare them for the final examinations, and we are happy that we did that. They worked with a team of teachers. I wish to thank the team of teachers who worked with these children. Pupils become the most important asset of the school. Without the school, without them and their teachers, the school is nothing. It is also true that a pupil is nothing or incomplete without a good teacher. So may I take the opportunity to thank all the teachers who worked with the children, and they really worked hard to prepare these children for the final examination. My farewell message to my friends, today you are my friends. Feel free to talk to me. I'm not scary anymore. There is a saying that everything that has a beginning must have an end. You began your journey through the school, Woodford School Lusaka, and today it has come to its end. Please look at me, I'm talking to you. It is always difficult. It is a difficult task to say goodbye to dear ones, but the Woodford School Lusaka family has no choice but to bid you farewell. We shall miss you, but it is time for you to leave us now. As you leave the four corners of the school, we should give you a farewell message that you must take with you. And as you leave the face of Woodford School and go into the secondary section world, primary school is for little ones. You're no longer little. Sorry, you're no longer little. Remember, I used to tell you that you are the senior most, and today we are saying bye-bye. Take with you all the good values we have taught you here at Woodford School Lusaka. While you were here, you learned so many things from everyone within the community, and your lives have been affected and touched by all that you embedded from being a pupil at Woodford School Lusaka. Learn to be yourselves. Do not copy things that you cannot manage. Well, after a few years of hard struggle, how many years from grade one to today? How many? You're adulting. How many? Grade one to now? How many years? 7 years. Now time has come to go into secondary section. A lot of temptations. Some of your friends who never listened to what their friends, what the adults told them, fell prey to the bad things that happen in older sections of the education system. You will have to face harder challenges in secondary school than ever before. However, never get fed up and continue to go ahead, having strong confidence and believe in yourselves. It is your belief, courage, patience, and hard work which will surely lead you ahead and give you a brighter future. Primary section was very easy. The teachers were very passionate, very patient with you, but in secondary section, you'll find the hard stuff. They won't care whether you do your homework or not, but remember, you will have to do it. They'll give you the work, but they'll not care whether you do it or not. Remember, I have always told you that a school is like a bus station. At the bus station, people meet, but at the end of the day, they go their ways. Woodford School, Lusaka, was your station. Now, you are going your own ways, different ways from here. But remain focused. My good wishes are always with you, and I wish you all the best. May God bless you. And thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Mrs. Siavanta. At this time, guest of honor, ladies and gentlemen, may I take this opportunity to invite the managing director, Mr. Polotia, to come and address us. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon, pupils.
Good afternoon, Mr. Polotia.
Thank you for pronouncing it correctly. Sometimes it's that follow. It's truly a wonderful day. We have reached a day to celebrate the leaving. Thank you. We have reached the day to celebrate the leaving of our first set of grade sevens. My family has been in schools, in private schools, for a very long time. For some of you who may not know, back in 1973, my parents bought a small school in Rhodes Park, which was called Rhodes Park School. Then 1980, they started primary. By 92, 93, when I took over, I'd already gone to secondary, and Rhodes Park School has been around for a long time. In 2013, we created this school as a new school that was going to spread the same services to another part of Lusaka. And we started out very small. We ended the first term with seven pupils. Seven. And then in January 2014, we started primary. We brought in Mrs. Siawanta, who had been our deputy head primary at Rhodes Park, and we asked her to be the head teacher here. Some of the pupils in here were the first to actually start the primary here. The ones we know, we will mention, has been mentioned before, people like Mr. Lungu. Mr. Lungu, I don't know you. May I just see you? Oh, I do know you. Hi. No, thank you very much for your support. Mrs. Siawanta mentioned how much it was a risk and a leap of faith that a lot of the parents who've trusted us with their pupils. If you remember this campus, where we are standing today, there was a forest. There were literally trees and trees and trees, and we had to bring in a big bulldozer to come and bring them down. We had to do so much construction, so much renovation, so much preparations in front of and behind the scenes. We had to adopt systems. You know, we had to bring in how are we going to teach, where are we going to teach, where are people going to sit, where are the toilets going to be, how is the water, the boreholes, electricity, everything. We had to bring in a new group of teachers and teach them, help them to understand how we wanted things to be taught within the Rhodes Park school system. And most of all, what we've had to do was to create the essence of what a Woodford school is like. Woodford School Lusaka is the first of the Woodfords. We are still planning another Woodford school in Kitwe, maybe Chingola, and some of the other towns. So the children have reached grade 7, and some of the parents are asking themselves, so what happens now? What do we do with our children? And if only Woodford had secondary, then they would have stayed. When we looked at the space that's available here on this campus, we made a decision that it's already getting quite full. We have about 450 pupils here already. If we were going to add secondary all the way up to grade 12, it would be quite congested. It wouldn't be the premium quality that the parents are paying for, by the way. So we decided, no, let's just stop Woodford at grade 7. Our plans as the Rhodes Park Group include that we're already working on a boarding school that's going to be in Chongwe. Chongwe gives us about 35 to 40 Ks out of Lusaka, maybe 40 minutes drive out of here. It's going to be a very large campus. We've already secured some good land there. We'll be starting construction next year. A very large campus with boarding houses and sports facilities and pools and libraries and everything. So we look forward to some of the pupils coming to join us there. Just to tell you the expected date that Ashford Academy, which is what we're calling that school, will be opening in January 2019. So that's the timeline that we've given ourselves. We'll be opening in grade 8 and in grade 10. And we're hoping to continue to have the support of the same parents that we've had with us. Parents from Woodford, from Rhodes Park, and from the other schools. In terms of quality, we'll be replicating exactly what we've been doing out there. I'm speaking mostly to the parents. Parents, you have had to endure many invoices, reminders, some challenges here and there, but you've done it out of the love and devotion that you have for your children. And we, as the board and management of Woodford School, we're so grateful to you and for your support. Some of you have got children that are still here with you. We promise you that the school will continue to improve as it has been improving, and will continue to take care of you. And yes, every once in a while, there are challenges in the service industry. You have to let us know. We'll always be listening. I want to say thank you and goodbye to the pupils. Some of you, I know, will be joining us at Rhodes Park School in a couple of months. And just to assure the parents that those pupils from Woodford who come to Rhodes Park School will be given priority in terms of entrance. After all, you are ours. What we do ask, though, is that if you are coming to Rhodes Park, then we try and get things done and communicated as soon as possible. It's always difficult in January, in the first couple of weeks of January, where there's a lot of results, reports, everything, and places. And sometimes my phone rings all the time. People call me at 0330 to ask for a school place, you know? And I don't know what to say to them at 0330 certificate. You've had a taste of what it's like out there to compete with people, to people across the country. You've been cooked. You've been brought, you've been taught drama, you've been taught music, you have gone on trips to different parts of the country. You know, we've been proud to have taken you on this journey, and we look forward to seeing you again. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you.
Thank you so much, Mr. Chisupa. Good afternoon, class of 2017. How are you doing?
We are very well, thank you, and how are you?
Thank you. The guest of honor, Honourable Vincent Mwale, Member of Parliament, Minister of Local Government and Housing, the Managing Director, Mr. Chisha Flotia, the head teacher, Mrs. Siawant, the teachers, parents present, distinguished invited guests, Grade 7 Class of 2017, ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to be part of this joyous and memorable farewell luncheon for the Grade 7 Class of 2017. Let me first express my warmest congratulations to you young graduates who have successfully gone through an important phase of study that lays the foundation of long life learning. Ladies and gentlemen, as you may be aware that the burden of providing education to our children is enormous and requires concerted efforts by everyone concerned. As a PTA for Woodford School, we are delighted to have been a part of the first journey of the children's education who are graduating to another part of life in their education cycle. To the class of 2017, my encouragement to you all is that continue carrying the Woodford School flag higher and higher wherever you may go. I am convinced that the knowledge and guidance that you have acquired from this school has laid a firm foundation that will in the future make you good standing citizens that will contribute greatly to the nation's development of our economy. To the parents, I wish to sincerely say thank you for your active contribution and efforts you have exhibited in ensuring that these our children attain the best education and moral uprightness of life. Once again, my warmest congratulations on your achievements at Woodford School Lusaka. May God continue guiding and lighting your path as you endeavor in your education. To the school management, on behalf of the PTA, I have no doubt that our partnership has contributed significantly to making learning more interesting and effective for our children. In this regard, I want to commend the school, the Woodford School management and the teachers for their tireless efforts in the provision of quality standards of education that they have continued to give to the learners. Keep up with the good work. In conclusion, ladies and gentlemen, as a PTA, we are always committed to supplementing the efforts of the school management in ensuring that financial, material, and other forms of support are given in order to lessen the burden in the provision of modern high standards of education at Woodford School, Lusaka. The class of 2017, I wish you every success in your future studies, and may the good Lord bless you. I thank you.
There is always a start to everything, beginning with life and what we do. And the class of 2017 is a start and a leap of Woodford School, Lusaka, and many more Woodford schools in Zambia to come and elsewhere on earth. So it's a big reminder to our leaders that we need to look beyond Zambia and establish Woodford School elsewhere. Guest of honor, the managing director, the PTA chairperson, the head teacher, may I, ladies and gentlemen, at this time invite our guest of honor to come and dress us. Honorable Minister, sir.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Let me start by recognizing the board of directors for the school, the managing director, Mr. Chisha Folotia. I got a different version earlier on. I think it was a combination of both Chisha and Folotia. I came up with something. The PTA chairperson, Mr. Raymond Ngoma, the head teacher, Mrs. Siawanta, parents and teachers, ladies and gentlemen, but I think most importantly, the students, the reason we're here. It is with pleasure that are accepted to be guests of honor at this important send-off luncheon for the grade 7 pupils at Woodford School, as we call it, the class of 2017. I do understand that this is the first grade 7 class at this school, and this is no easy task. The establishment of this school is in line with government's policy of education for all. And according to the 7th National Development Plan, government's priorities or priority areas are for the general education subsectors, access and participation, equality and relevance of education, and equity. I would like to reiterate government's commitment to quality education to ensure economic growth. This is very, very important. When I was Minister of Youth and Sport, I kept talking to lots of young people that I met. If we look at what's happening in Zimbabwe now, where the economy is not doing very well, the country has still managed to survive simply because they did the right thing by investing in the skills of the young people. We have here in Zambia now the people that are roofing our houses being Zimbabweans, the people that are doing tiling, the people that are doing construction. In South Africa, you have more than 3 million Zimbabwean young people that are in the construction sector. And those people are sending back to Zimbabwe a lot of remittances that are keeping the economy vibrant. So the investment in the education sector that was done a long time ago in Zimbabwe and continues to be done is keeping that country the levels it is now. And some of the people have gone to Europe and all sending money back to Zimbabwe. Now this is what we have to do as a country. We have to make sure we invest in the education system, not just by sending kids to school, but having the right curriculum that will educate our young people to be able to stand on their own. Young people that will develop into entrepreneurs, like Mr. Folotia himself, who started this school as we heard, or this whole business from the scratch. And now he's talking about going to Chongwe, and there's a call now for him to extend all the way to other countries. And I was inviting him to go to our neighbors, Malawi, after doing his business here. But this is what we want to see, that amongst ourselves, I mean young people, our students, they should be image real entrepreneurs that will carry forward dreams like this one. Woodford School opened in 2013 and has since grown and produced first grade 7 class. Congratulations to the board of directors and school management for this great achievement. Parents, let me say I want to thank you for the support that you have rendered to your children. You supported them throughout their academic work, and I think that it is evident that all of them have managed, they went in and all of them have managed to pull through up to the very end. Bringing these children to this school is a sign of your commitment to national development. You place so much confidence in the school management and it has paid off. To the learners, let me begin by saying you are special. You are so special. And I was saying to Mr. Folotia and others that from the look of things and from my own inner feeling, I think that we are going to get 100% pass rate. This is how I see things from my side. I'm very, very confident that each of these candidates that sat for the exams will make it to grade 8. I'm reliably informed that you just ended the grade 7 examinations at 9 hours this morning. It has just marked the start of a high level of academic experience, which is secondary education. Like you, like us, you sat behind your desk and paid attention. You participated in all school programs. These programs were not only designed to train you for grade 7 examination, but for future as well. And this is what I was talking about earlier on, that our job as government is to be able to develop the curriculum that will not just prepare students for examinations, but beyond the examinations, they must be able to stand on their own, survive and run this country, that we should stop looking up to foreigners or people from other countries, you know, to do things for us, as we say, Zimbabweans, Chinese, and so on, to come and do some things for us. I believe that you have passed with flying marks, as I say. Boys and girls, I'm counting on you to be the future teachers, pilots, doctors, businessmen, government leaders. We're looking forward to you occupying the National Assembly in the near future. Therefore, focus on your goals and dreams. You will achieve much if you focus. I know we have a challenge. I'm a parent as well. The challenge that we have is that there's too much gaming, games, to some extent, drugs and things like that, that all parents all over the world are now wondering what is going to happen to the future generations or the generations that we have. We've lost our children. They will not listen to us. They will listen to games. They will pay attention to games and everything else. And there's so many programs that are being put up in many countries to try and promote family union and values and making sure that we get back somehow, you know, to how things used to happen in the past. We've really lost our children, many of us. But I think that the training that you got here must have given you, you know, something to make us smile as your parents. And I can see, I was saying, each time, you know, previous speakers greeted you and greeted back in a uniform manner. And I said, there must be discipline here. You know, I hope that I can enroll my kids to this school, because that is admirable. This is as it should be. You will achieve much more if you focus. To management, let me applaud you for the achievement today. And I want to thank you very much for listening to me. God bless you.
Thank you so much, our guest of honor, for the timely words of advice that you have given to the institution and to the grade 8 2018 learners. At this time, guest of honor, ladies and gentlemen, may I invite you, the guest of honor, Honorable Minister, the Managing Director, the PTA Chairperson, the Head Teacher, to come up for certification of the 2017 Class of Intellectuals. Guest of Honor, recently I took this class to Parliament and they learnt one or two words. Like which ones? And which word else?
Question!
Thank you, sir. So, as you rightly put it, there will be parliamentarians very soon. At this time, we are going to begin to give the certificates to our learners, and we will bid farewell in such a way. I will call the name, and then when the learner comes in, gets the certificate, the parents, you are free to come and jubilate with the learner for a short while. Those children who have not given hugs, it will be the best opportunity to do so. So, ladies and gentlemen, the calling is in no particular order. Let me begin with Julian Chabran Osman. Where's your gown? He wants to be seen in a suit. That's a future MP for Lusaka Central. That's Julian.
Where'd your head at?
Don't forget your head. Thank you. Oh, sorry. Sorry, madam. Parents are very far. Oh. Let's give you a hand. Thank you so much, to be followed by, oh. Yeah, so those are the parents to one of the parliamentarians. We have Chengelo Chitimbe. Chengelo, she wants to be a medical doctor when she leaves the University of Zambia. Before Chengelo leaves the podium, I want to invite the twin sister, Chimwemwe Chitimbe. Chengelo, can you come back? The parents. The next one is Hamwenda Mbozi. Thank you. Hamwenda Mbozi. That's our future Minister of Local Government and Housing. Thank you. The next one is Olive Jibola. That's Olive. I want to be a pediatrician. She wants to be a pediatrician. That's great. The parents. Oh, yes. Thank you so much. The next one is Dalitso Banda. One day, Dalitso asked me a question. Mr. Supa, is it possible to eat everything in the exams? I said, yes, but do not use your teeth. Use your pencil and you will eat everything. So we have a high calling there. Thank you. Next is Mapalo Mando Chitamfia. That's Mapalo. Next time you should replace mom to be on the list of guests very soon. Thank you so much. Next is Ndanji Namfukwe. She wants to be a businesswoman when she grows up. So, thank you so much. Next is Wongani Lungu. That's Wongani, who plans to be a public speaker one day. So very soon it will materialize. Before Wongani would sit, I want to call upon the twin brother, Wonjezani Lungu. Yes. He knows where the minister is. Yeah, thank you. After the twin brothers, we have Toela Nicole Chavula. With the plans of becoming a medical doctor. Oh, mommy is coming. We'll hold on for you. Thank you. After the young doctor, we have Kaliwe Kachali. Kaliwe told me when I asked, what do you want to do in life when you grow up? And she told me, nothing else, just become president. So we have a president in the making. After Kaliwe, we have Carlos Afonso. I just forgot the word we use in Portuguese when a greeting. Carlos told me.
Bom dia.
Oh, bom dia. Thank you so much. And the minister also knows. So we have a high commissioner in the making. Coming from Angola, that is Carlos Afonso. To crown it all, I don't know who taught me these words, that usually short people do it better and in style because of the challenge. Apparently, I share halfway that challenge. We have
and keep the noise down.
Hey, let me get the picture.
Keep the noise to a minimum.
We got y'all, we won't be no trouble.
Never.
Don't call the cops, just call us.
Hey, okay. I want y'all to do this dance now.
Thank you so much. Let's give them a big hand. Thank you so much. At this time, we will invite the class teacher for this class, Mr. Chisupa. You are welcome. Thank you so much for that wonderful invitation. You know, when there's no one to invite you, just do it yourself. It's very, very important. Guest of honor, the managing director, the PTA chairperson, the head teacher, all dignitaries, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, may I say thank you so much to our dear parents for entrusting these young souls into our hands. It has not been easy from January to date. We fought quite a lot. We fought quite a lot from homework to classwork, projects, trips. I remember when we went to Paravana for an excursion, one of our daughters, after she saw pigs for the very first time in life, she could no longer see. And she said, "Mr. Tsumba, these are the pigs. I think I'm going blind." It's quite interesting. So this is a child who has seen pigs on television for a long time. By the way, the pigs they've been seeing are on Cartoon Network. Sometimes they are colored green, orange, but at least a real one was seen. What am I saying? It's not been easy to deliver the right message to the young ones. Because in grade 7, they are grown, they are able to think, they are able to process. When you say something, they want to understand, and they'll put it in another way. However, we've come this far. Thank you so much, our dear parents, for the support that you render to us. On behalf of the teachers who are handling these children, we want to thank management for that trust that you had in us, that when you gave us these children, you knew we're going to handle them in a nice way. Today, they are big. You've seen their beautiful gowns. Tomorrow, they'll be bigger. And as they leave Woodford School into secondary school, there'll be more challenges that they are going to encounter and bring forth before you. Please have patience with them. Do not shout at them. You see, Mr. Chupa was very lenient to you. Now things have changed. Yes, things will continue changing. For them to become politicians, they will need to stand the pressure all the time. Young boys and girls, you are going out of primary education level. It will not be the same. Like our leaders spoke, it will not be the same. The teachers you will meet, please carry the Woodford banner wherever you go. It is a symbol. When you are challenged, humble yourselves and you will overcome the way you did it here. Thank you so much. May God bless you as you get into a bigger world. Thank you so much, Mr. Chisupa, for those words. Thank you so much. There's one boy who told me these words one day. You know, the way you talk, I think when I get your age, I'll talk better than you. And I think that talking, I want to challenge him now and have it better than me today. May I invite Wongani Lungu to come up front. Wongani Lungu is coming in with a vote of thanks.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Chisupa. The guest of honor, Honourable Mr. Vincent Mwale, Minister of Local Government, the Managing Director, Mr. Folotia, the Head Teacher, Mrs. Siabwanta, the PTA Chairperson, Mr. Ngoma, dear parents, teachers, my fellow grade 7 learners, may I simply say, all invited guests, the guest of honor, sir, the wise say, time is never a friend, as it flies faster than one wonders. It is recent that we are seeing this day. We imagined it, we dreamt it, and we are eager for it. Today, we are here. Guest of honor, sir, we gather here to say bye to this lovely institution. The school led us on a journey we'll never forget. As a kickstart to life, we are grateful that Woodford School Lusaka has played that role. Guest of honor, sir, we want to appreciate the following. The board of directors for the introduction of the school close to our residences. Woodford School Lusaka teachers, without you, we wouldn't be here today. The homework, lessons, projects, and tests they gave us will always be remembered. The excursions we had locally and internationally were just great. We traveled extensively within Zambia, Namibia and Zimbabwe. Thank you to Woodford School Lusaka. Our dear parents, for the support given through at our stay at this great school. You drove us every day and from school bought us sumptuous meals and the school fees. No one can ever do what you did for us. Even as we go to secondary schools, we urge you to continue supporting us. Guest of honor, sir, our prayer is that the school we have helped to grow being the first grade seven pupils will continue with the growth and much influx of learners. Guest of honor, sir, it is not a mistake, neither will it ever be, to have been part of Woodford School Lusaka. I want to urge our dear parents to bring our brothers and sisters to this school. This is the best school. And finally, guest of honor, sir, may I congratulate my fellow pupils for high marks to be recorded and automatic entrant into secondary school. Mr. Chisupa always told us that we are eagles who fly than cliffs with a long vision. Guest of honor, sir, I thank you.
Thank you so much. I'm sure you see that there is a better Chisupa now. At this time, may I invite the class of 2017 to be close by here because they have a piece of presentation. Them here because I want to be those who are photocopiers can photocopy them with the activity that is going on. May I invite Shiza up front here and Olive. So Shiza and Olive will cut the cake. Just two small pieces. As they sing, then the ladies behind will help us with the cutting and the distribution. Shiza, there's a knife there, and Olive. Those who are, I want the minister to see the way you are. So that map of Zambia we saw on TV one time during independence, you'll be the ones to cut so that he has that experience that, no, I know. Okay? Okay, that is Shiza and Olive. Good.
You can slice and remove two slices there. Thank you so much. This. Okay. Get another one. First. This cake is a contribution and a thank you to Woodford School Lusaka by a parent, by a couple, parents of one of our learners, Mr. and Mrs. Kachari. May you just wave where you are. There they are. Thank you so much. Thank you. Okay, thank you. You may test those. Then you go and do. I want them to photocopy you. Oh, that's beautiful. Thank you so much. Ladies at the back, please, you may assist us. At this time, I will invite the class of 2017 to give us a piece of music. Thank you so much. May descend the podium. Tell it so. All the boys and girls want as they please just me. May I request that Miss Tisha. Oh, thank you. May I request that you save the high table, and as the others are serving elsewhere, they will sing, they will present something, we'll have some music, and then shortly we'll be closing down. Bye.
hip hip hooray!
Thank you so much. You may take seat, boys and girls.
Father, we give you praise and glory. We thank you for your mercies. We thank you that, Lord, you've been good to us. Thank you for this wonderful time that we've spent in your presence, Almighty God. Thank you for our children that have put in so much hard work. We're praying that, Lord, it may pay off, that, oh God, you will enable them, Almighty Father, to make it in life. We thank you that their future is bright, and mighty God, they will succeed in all that they do. We thank you for the commitment of the parents. We thank you for the school authorities, for our guest of honor, for each and every one of us that are represented today, Almighty God. We are praying, be exalted, be lifted, and as the day unfolds, be in total control. We surrender everything to you. In Jesus' name we pray, thanks. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you so much. May I request that we all rise as we usher out the minister. Thank you so much. Thank you, may you be seated.
Be believers, be leaders, be astronauts, be champions.